People shocked a group of protesting players yesterday when they see what's really bizarre. If you're not yet sick and tired of the NFL protesting the national anthem, just wait, there's still time. The protest is still in full swing, as it seems to be fueled by every bit of controversy surrounding it. It's leading many of us to ask ourselves why it's even still going on after the considerable dent that the subsequent NFL boycott has put in their earnings. Even though this protest has been the worst thing that could happen to the bottom line of the league and the teams that make it up, they seem to be too afraid of their players to put an end to it. Because if you put an end to something that has been accepted as politically correct, that makes you a racist, or sexist, or bigot or whatever the closest PC accepted slur might be. So what are these protesting players fighting for? According to conservative pundit Alan B. West, what they're supposedly fighting for is the very thing that should negate their platform. Some players in the NFL are still kneeling to protest inequality, but the crazy thing is, they go on to play a game which celebrates that very thing. They play to win, to be better than the opposing team. To be unequal. Where is the justice in that? Saturday night, the Houston Astros defeated the New York Yankees and will go on to play in the Baseball World Series, the Fall Classic. How many teams are there in the MLB? We know one thing for certain, there will only be one who holds up the championship trophy. We gather for sporting events and cheer for our favorite teams to win, and are seriously discouraged when they don't. Man, my heart sank when Oklahoma scored a 22-yard touchdown with 0-7 left to beat my Kansas State Wildcats. The reality is that everyone takes the field of competition, but there will always, only, be one champion. We don't go to these sporting events to see anyone determine the outcomes except for the players on the field. We certainly don't go just to see everyone have a great time participating and no one keeping score. We love the competition. And we love to play Queen's song, "We Are the Champions," not "We Are the Participators." In the game of sports, these teams are free to compete, and each has the opportunity to win. And that means one thing: they are not all equal. If all of these teams in all sports were made to be equal, then they are not free. And they don't have opportunity, as someone else will be determining their outcomes. And so it goes, why do we want that to be the means by which our lives are determined? If we are indeed a free people, then we are not equal. We all have our respective talents, abilities, and competencies that in a free society we're able to develop. I was never intended to be a college-level athlete. Nor was it in the works for me to be a renowned artist, musician or engineer. However, I was free to pursue my happiness, and with the grand opportunities this great nation affords have been successful in my own ability. This is the same for us all. Now, some have the disturbing, distorted and delusional perspective that they can render us all equal to some degree. We are then no longer free, as our lives, our outcomes, are determined, regulated, or prescribed by others. Instead of being the officials and referees to ensure theirs is a level playing field of opportunity for us to win, they instead try to create the winners, according to their ideology and agenda. The poison of social egalitarianism tells us there's no exceptionalism. That Alabama would have to give up, forfeit points to Tennessee in order to make it a fair game. According to whom? Free throws in basketball are not just given, they're awarded when someone commits a foul. A walk in baseball doesn't just happen when you show up with bat in hand. It's given if you're skilled enough not to strike out, and the pitcher isn't skilled enough to throw a strike. The progressive socialist left will say this is oversimplified. It's not. Life isn't about penalizing and taking away from others what they've accomplished, what they've earned and achieved. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, not guarantee of happiness, is what makes America special, unique and exceptional. It's the reason why people can come from anywhere in the world with nothing, and with their own drive and determination become winners. Champions. We need to reject this notion of being an equal people. Being free means we're not equal. And that, folks, is a good thing. The one thing that every liberal pretends doesn't exist, and every conservative can't stop seeing, is that when we see players protesting, they're doing so from an inherently unequal place in life. They don't step down from their coveted position because they had a better coach than some other kid who maybe had equal talent. It's bizarre to even imagine a world where there's someone going around, tracing their way back through our lives to find out if we've had any benefit that someone else hasn't had, and taking something away from us if we have. If that were the case, we wouldn't need to work for a greater future for our children, because it wouldn't matter. If we gave it to them, someone would just take it away, and if we didn't, someone would just even the score. Equality is something that can only be obtained in potential. You still have the potential in this country to make anything you want out of yourself. The outcome is up to you.